आंखों ही आंखों में इशारा हो गया, बैठे बैठे जीने का सहारा हो गया, आंखों ही आंखों में.
We see the whole world through the eyes. The baby, when he's born, first cries and sees his mom, sees all the different creatures with his eyes. When we meet the person for the first time, it is the eyes which tell the story. Is the person welcoming you? Not welcoming you? When you go to college for the first time, it is through the eyes that we come to know whether this person has a liking for you. Friends, eyes say a lot. It is said that even if you don't speak anything, eyes reveal everything. And that's the reason why eyes have so much of importance. Amongst all the senses, this sense is so important, because if you close your eyes, it's just darkness. I mean, there may be some vision inside the inner being, but to see the world, one has to have eyes. It's said the most vital organ is not the heart, it's not the kidneys, it's the eyes. Although they do not do any functions of sustaining the body as such, but yet without the eyes, well, it is next to impossible to survive. And I wonder how people who have not been given that sense, or that sense is not working as good as R is working, if that sense is disturbed, what can happen? Well, all of us know to a certain extent what can happen. We are on a bike without a helmet or a goggle, and some small speck of dirt goes in our eyes, we know what happens. Yeah, we know what happens. It's a major sort of a calamity if something goes in the eye, eye become red, and you really get perturbed by all these things. Friends, today we are going to discuss how homeopathy can be of use in different eye conditions. This is the diagram of the eye, the most important, useful for all of us. Grossly, the eye is divided into this anterior chamber and the posterior chamber. The lens, you can see the iris, which gives color to the eye. Then we have the three layers, the conjunctiva, the sclera, and the retina, the most sensitive part inside. Then the optic nerve, which takes away which has got rods and cones here, the retina, which takes away the sensations which are perceived in the optic cortex. The pupil, the aperture, which keeps on opening and closing depending upon the amount of light. And the lens, which depending upon how you see, how much distance, it keeps on moving. So friends, as many physiological things in the as many anatomical and physiological things in the eye, these problems can arise anywhere at whichever level this gets disturbed. Today we'll discuss all the common areas where we can use the help of homeopathy. The commonest is the red eye. Commonest. Whenever a patient comes with us, first thing is the red eye. Aankh laal ho gaya hai, dekhiye kya ho sakta hai. It can be anything. It can be conjunctivitis, the bacterial infection, the viral infection, the allergic states, the hay fever like states, along with fever. It can be a dust organ, a dust, a speck of dust. It can be some insect bite. It can be rubbing the eyes vigorously. It can be bad sanitary habits. Reasons can be anything, or it can be a systemic illness. It can be a cardiac illness. Reasons can be anything. But one should understand, a red eye is the first symptom of the eye throwing symptoms, having some problem. Dry eyes can also give rise to severe red eye. Even sometimes in fever, we can have red eye. This is the most common condition. In homeopathy, we treat symptoms. So whatever the pathology may be, that's important. But we see the symptoms first. Let us relieve the symptoms. These are the important drugs in homeopathy. The euphrasia, or the eye bright as it is called. A marked intolerance to light. The euphrasia patient will say, stop this light, I close it, please close it, it's coming too much. A sort of a photophobia, also seen in Kali Bai. Aconite nepalis, marked by its rapid onset like belladonna, sudden onset like belladonna. Ailment from cold winds, red bloodshot eyes, hot, gritty and swollen, calls for aconite, one of our important drugs of not just red eye, but you will see this drug coming almost everywhere in many eye conditions. Apis mellifica, one of our very good drugs for the allergic states. We have discussed also this in the urticaria. Apis is nothing but a bee. Stinging, itching eyes, and a relief, marked relief with cold compresses, swollen and pinkish lids. Apis will always treat you well if these conditions are present, will never fail you because of its marked affinity towards allergy and to eye states in general. Where there is burning, there is arsenic. Arsenic is one of our prominent burners of our Mother America, along with sulfur. These create a lot of burning, and almost all cases of this burning, if these symptoms match, and better by warm applications, midday, midnight aggravation, arsenic will be the drug of choice. Doctor sahab, mere bacche ki exam aayi hai, usko kuch tonic dijiye jisse wo hushyar ho jayega. Main kehta hu mere paas aisa tonic nahi hai, koi kisi ko hushyar nahi bana sakta, but yes, we can give him some medicine with which at least his eye strain will be better. He has to read for long hours, you know, you feel strained, your lids drop. But with our homeopathic medications, at least this strain and stress can be taken care of. We'll see it later. Now, eye strain. What is eye strain? Is continuous straining of eyes. Maybe watching on computer or watching 3 movies in a day. All these are also a part of eye strains. Or seeing a cricket match continuously. I have a patient who is an umpire, and he says that I can't even blink my eyes, it's such a pressure job. I said, now you're a third umpire, you can just raise it. He said, third umpires are there more for all the international matches, but what about our grassroots matches? What about these Ranjis and the Kanga leagues? We don't have this facility, and one has to be constantly very active, very cautious that you don't miss even a single frame. The editors also, they can't miss a single frame, and they have to finish a job in a couple of hours. So these people land up getting huge amount of pain and swelling, heaviness on the eyes, and we'll see now different drugs which can be used for such eye strains. Aconite again, this may bring relief where foreign matters get into the eye. The person feels fearful and agitated. The arsenic mind is full of fear. Sensitivity, heavy watering and heightened sensitivity to light. Apis coming up again. The eyelids and surrounding areas are very puffy and tender. Apis produces, what happens when you get a bee sting? Swelling, bleeding a bit, redness, stinging and edema and puffiness. So this is sort of a doctrine of signature, and hence Apis mellifica also produces these symptoms, and hence can also remove these symptoms in a diseased individual. Apis can also be useful after overexposure to very bright light. We saw this, looking at snow in bright sunlight, or sun reflecting off water for long periods, driving into the sun. The last two are more common for us, right? Whenever the eyes feel sore and oversensitive. Next drug, very important friends, which we have not yet touched on, is argentum nitricum. Aching from overuse of detailed work, relieved by closing the eyes or pressing on them. See, what is detailed work? Detailed work is not a gross work. It's fine work. People who chisel. You know, even a small millimeter here and there can create problems. And the whole picture can go astray. The artists who are constantly cannot blink the eye because of the detailing of work. If we see this area, detailing of the work has to be done. and eye strain because of detailing. The muscles around the eye feel weak and a person is unable to keep them focused and steady. The white and the corners looked inflamed as a conjunctiva. Being in an overheated room may aggravate the symptoms. This drug arnica will never fail you. Almost everywhere where strain is involved, sprain is involved, overuse is involved, whether it's the vocal cords, whether it's your bicep muscles, whether it's the ladies who are constantly working in the kitchen and they get a back pain, whether it's a patang season and you are suddenly getting a shoulder pain, or some enthusiast who sees young children playing in the society cricket and you go down and Mr. Sonawale does some bowling and Mr. Lad does some wicket keeping and suddenly they develop back pain and they miss out on a good lecture. But then this arnica will help them to come out of these symptoms. Any strain at a level of muscles, anywhere, arnica is a drug of choice. Remedy can be bring relief to a person with bruised, sore feeling in the eyes after a closely focused work. The person may feel a need to keep the eyes open, getting dizzy when closing them. Kalifos is one of our nerve remedies. We are aware of it. Kalifos is one of our biochemical remedies also. And Kalifos can be useful in exhaustion from illness, where post-illness, Kalifos is one of our drugs for post-illness. We have a dengue epidemic going on. Everywhere there is dengue. In fact, I would like to speak about this, that one of my teachers, Dr. Sunil Anand, is conducting a huge research in Pune in a KM hospital on dengue. And they have visited the dengue ward in KEM hospital and they have found out a drug which we called as genus epidemicus. The genus epidemicus is tabacum 200, which has been given. So I appeal to all my friends who are watching this that please, this drug is of utmost importance and let's help genus epidemicus, which means,
is this a vaccine?
I will talk about it in some time. So this is a homeopathic drug and you can take it. It's available free also in many areas because you want to do a good work. And the symptoms are abating. The platelet count is gradually increasing. Okay. And also the general malaise and the bone pains, the back pain also is reducing. Yes, is decreasing. Now why I mentioned about this is that because Kalifos is also useful in cases where there is eye pain, where there is any muscle pain post fever. When a patient says, I am not recovering well after that illness, well, we think of Kalifos. Okay, so Kalifos is a good drug where there is helpful after exhaustion from illness, overwork and stress, eye strain. The eyes feel very weak and tired and vision seems blurred and weak. A person who needs this remedy often startles easily and is oversensitive to light. Kalmia, one of our important pain remedies, used as a pain in the heart as well, like spiralgia. Great stiffness felt in the eyes and the eyelids. Worst, moving the eyes. The vision may seem to be impaired or weak. A person who needs this remedy may also have nerve pains in face and teeth or joint and muscle stiffness and shifts from place to place. So kalmia we are using in different type of pains, as I said. We also employ kalmia in trigeminal neuralgia. Okay, where the pain comes this way, where the pain is in the face, the prosopalgia as we call. Okay, along with the pain in the eyes, along with the weakness and tiredness in the eyes. Kalmia latiflora. Now this remedy I was talking about for all these ladies who want their sons and daughters to score good marks. Let's read this. This remedy may be useful if extended periods of reading or doing school work have led to a weak, bruised feeling in the eyes. The muscle around the eyeballs can feel weak and stiff and the letters on a page may appear to run together. The eyelids feel heavy and the person may be inclined towards headaches. Natremur is one of our important remedies for migraineous headaches. In fact, my research on migraine revealed that most of the people with migraine may require Natremur because of its symptom richness in areas of head. The eye pain also is seen in migraines. The weakness of the eyes, the ptosis also sometimes is seen in migraine, and Natremur is one of our good remedies. But here we are talking about weakness and for a child to sustain the reading when you go for exams and you're reading for 14 hours, 15 hours every day, you can take Natramur so that the eyes don't feel weak. Symphytum. Symphytum is a friend which we use many a times in fractures. A lot of research has revealed that, you know, symphytum helps in reunion and osteoneogenesis. It helps the fracture approximation better and the healing better. But here, it's a remedy again for bruised or injured feeling, or a bluntness, or a feeling of a pain, soreness in the eyes. Injuries to the eyeball can be serious and should always be examined by a doctor. Fine, fair enough. So this is about, yes, about weakness of the eye muscles, weakness of the eyes, straining of the eyes. Ruta is another medicine which we have not discussed, because I'm going to discuss entire eye remedies later, towards the last, which contains different you see eye conditions. Blepharitis. Now look at this inflamed red, often itchy, and look at this. This is blepharitis, so common. It's very common. Patients come to us more so because of cosmetic reasons, and you can't see it. Allergies, pains, it pains, and also it keeps on watering. It affects you. It affects your overall efficiency. Blepharitis. Now let us see the blepharitis remedies. Start from here. The borax. Eyelids are gummy, crusty, and sticky. A desire to rub the eyelids. Borax. Borax is also one of our important remedies for aphthous ulcer states in the mouth, oral cavity. Graphitis, one of our very, very important remedies for the eye state. Red and swollen eyelids that are sticky in the morning. Hiparsulf, also remedy for ulcers. Eyelids are red and are sensitive to both the wind and to cold air. Pulsatilla. Both the eyelids are inflamed and sticky, and the condition is more in the winter season. Sorinum, again a winter remedy. Eyelids feel sticky and discharge is acidic. Edges of the eyelids are red in color. Sanicula, again hypersensitive to light, a feeling of dryness under the eyelids. Thuja, edges of the eyelids are dry and scaly, eyelids stick together at night. One would feel that these are all same symptoms. How do we differentiate? That's the beauty of homeopathy. We just don't go on the eye symptoms. We take a good history. We ask about the thirst. We ask about the entire personality. We ask about the stool and the urine. We ask about your sleep. We ask about a lot of other things of the past, present, because we prescribe the person, not the eye. Yes, these symptoms are important, but along with these, other symptoms of the mind, other symptoms of disposition, other symptoms are also important. Again, very important, and again very common, sty. It occurs to us so many times. Well, antibiotics are given, they are subsided, and again after some time, the sty comes up. What to do? Well, the answer is a good homeopathic medicine. Styes are small boils that occur in the eyelid. Irritation of the eyelid affected is often the first sign that is noticed and is soon followed by redness, pain, and swelling. This is a stye. Very, very common state. Nothing to do with the eye, with the eyelid. The only thing is it pains sometimes and you don't feel. The eye is so important, so vital organ, you don't want anything around it. And to get an injury to eye also is difficult, because the Almighty has kept the eyes in a socket of the orbit. Whereby anything comes, the first this will get injured. You know, you, unless it's a very sharp instrument, or unless it's a, you know, very you know, forceful trauma, the eyes don't get affected, because God has kept the eyes in a covering.
Unless your reflexes are very slow.
He has kept the eyes in a covering. There are bones here which are protecting your eye. There's a nose here which protects it from this side. Okay? That's the beauty of the human body. Let's start again now. This Apis is coming up again. Apis, graphitis, pulsatilla are such important drugs for eye states. Natramur, aconite. Apis for recurrent styes. Eyelids become swollen and sharp. Piercing pain, burning pain. conjunctiva becomes red. We are seeing apis the third or fourth time in this discussion. Again, graphitis, eyelids are dry, red and scaly, and there is an intolerance of artificial light. Lycopodium fasties in the inner corner of the eye. This is the inner canthi, as we call. Eyelids become red and ulcerate. Pulsatilla, very important drug. Many a times we start with pulsatilla because of the symptom similarity. A thick, profuse yellow discharge. Eyelid become inflamed and stick together. Eyes itch and burn. Pulsatilla. Cilicia. Eyes feel tender to touch. There is an aversion to light as it causes sharp pains which run through the eye. Cilicia. The staphysagria for recurrent styes and margin of the eyelid appear sunken. Staphysagria often follows pulsatilla. Now from these very common states, we move on to a more difficult to treat state, which is called as a dry eye. Dry eye can be because of many reasons. When we get a dry eye, we also ask him, do you get a dry mouth as well? The patient many times says yes. We ask him, do you get hand pains as well? The person says yes. And then we diagnose that maybe he has a form of rheumatoid arthritis. Maybe he has a form of autoimmune disorder. Maybe he has something called as Sjogren's syndrome or keratoconjunctivitis sicca. So whenever a patient comes with dry eyes, we ask him other symptoms because it's an overall picture of an autoimmune state. It's not such an easy state to treat, and it's not such an easy state to have also. We do not know the importance of things when we have it. Just imagine 203 bones in the body all working so well, so many muscles are moving it. We are not realizing its importance because everything is running normal. Ask a person of muscular dystrophy and he'll say that moving a hand is the most difficult thing on earth. Ask a person with dry eyes and he will say, I wish my eyes had some lubrication. It's such a bad thing. I have to keep on putting drops in the eyes and drops in my mouth to just keep it watery. So friends, I'm again repeating, let us cherish this good health which the Almighty has given us. Let us thank God that thank you, and don't just plead to him that I want this. Let's thank him that I am very happy that you have given me good eyes, good pair of hands, good muscles. Yeah, I can eat, I can enjoy the food, I have got taste. There's so many people who cannot enjoy the taste because of so many problems. So dry eyes looks like a small problem, but it's a very, very, very serious disorder. Because when there is no lubrication, there is no saliva, this means you have a tendency to formation of ulcers also. You have severe pain, you get redness, you get infection. Because this liquid which comes also has anti-infective properties and doesn't allow the infection to set in. Do you follow? And well, we have treated a few patients of dry eyes, but it's not such a huge achievement, I would say. But symptomatically, the patient may feel better. We give constitutional medication, but aconite also is one of our specific drugs for dry eyes. Eyes are red, inflamed, feel dry and hot, as if sand in them. Lids swollen, dry and hard, hate to light, profuse watering after exposure to dry cold winds. Aconite. And also important symptom is the dryness is so much that he has to rub his eyes all the time. They become red, bloodshot eyes, aconite. We can also give a drug called as bryonia, which is also known for a dryness it produces. Glaucoma, which is commonly called as kaach bindu, which is treatable condition. But unfortunately, it is not caught so well early in our Indian setting, especially in rural India. It aggravates, and people even lose vision because of this glaucoma. The idea is eye checkup should be there regularly, and patients should be trained right from school that if you see anything which is, you know, you get pressure in the eyes, you start getting floaters, okay, you get headaches, you see blurred things, you must report to a ophthalmologist or a optician, even if possible, or a doctor immediately. Okay, glaucoma is treatable. Lots of money has been spent by the government of India to spread awareness about glaucoma because it's a treatable illness, and it is the most important cause for blindness, which is treatable. It is not something impossible. Let's see the drug gelsemium. Eye signs are eyelids heavy, glaucoma and dim sightedness, pupils dilated and unaware of light, orbital neuralgia, detached retina, hysterical amblyopia. Another drug is the physostigma, one of our important drugs in eye conditions. Many patients come to us and say that mere bacche ko chasma hai, chasma kam kar sakte hain kya? Now, you know, it's a very tricky situation for scrupulous doctors. Technically, the patient can come to you and take medicines for 2 years, 3 years, and you are very happy that he has taken medicines from you, your meter is on. But somewhere it pinches you that, are you really doing anything? So I am not treating patients of myopia and presbyopia, and presbyopia is different, but myopia and childhood, amblyopia, I am not treating it. I tell them that you eat well, do some eye exercises, and we can take the medicines for 2 months and let's see, we'll stop later. This drug physostigma also is supposed to increase the power of the eyes, increase the accommodation of the eye muscles. Okay. Eye signs are glaucoma and light blindness, photophobia, contraction of pupils, twitching of ocular muscles, partial blindness, paresis of accommodation, astigmatism, a spasm of ciliary muscles with irritability after using eyes, and increasing myopia. Drug of choice is physostigma. I had mentioned Ruta some time back. Ruta is a drug again for stress and strain. Strain in the eyes after too much reading, Ruta is the remedy of choice. All parts of the body are painful as if bruised. Feeling of intense weakness. Deep pressure in the orbits. Deep pressure. Pressure over the eyebrows. Eye strain followed by headache. Disturbance of accommodation. Very pain while reading and asthenopia. Spigelia, another remedy, which is a heart remedy also, pain remedy also, a remedy for migraine also, a remedy for orbital neuralgias also. Eye signs feel too large, pressive pain in turning them. Pupils are dilated. Photophobia, rheumatic ophthalmia. Rheumatic ophthalmia means, as I said, certain states which are autoimmune have rheumatic symptoms also along with ophthalmic symptoms. We have some syndromes called as Tolosa-Hunt syndrome and superior orbital fissure syndrome, where along with rheumatism, the superior orbital nerve gets pressed and you get severe pain in the eye region. Okay, now this comes grossly under ophthalmoplegias. Severe pain in and around the eyes, extending deep into the socket. A neurological signs of serial neuralgia and a true neuritis. Friends, these were the common states we saw: the glaucoma, the conjunctivitis, the red eye, the eye strains, the blepharitis, and the sty. These are the common areas where we see our patients. But sometimes patients do come to us for ARMD, which is macular degeneration. It's yet to be conquered. Even modern medicine is finding it difficult to conquer such states where the vision starts going down and down and down and down. Now, I'll answer. We'll take it in sequence. So friends, ARMD also needs a multiple approach treatment where it's believed that certain antioxidants are useful. Yoga, positive thinking, good foods are useful. Eliminating the free radicals is useful. Stem cell therapy also is useful. And certain injections also are proved to be of use. And we are treating a lot of patients of ARMD. And we can say that yes, we have at least stopped the further degeneration. That his vision is not further deteriorated. But to get back the vision, it's difficult because it is not possible anatomically. If those areas are disturbed, if those areas are dead, how can you get those areas back to life? We are treating these patients of ARMD, but a lot of more research is to be required. Squinting. Now, squinting is not so easy to be treated medically. Many doctors do attempt do broadcast themselves that yeah, they can treat squints. But squint is basically a surgical condition. It has to be treated with surgery under the good care of an ophthalmologist. However, if the squint is because of certain stroke, in stroke also you can get squint, in meningitis one can get squint, then that can be treated. That's very transient, it will go away when the meningitis is settled. One of my first patients of medical practice was a chalazion patient. Chalazion is a tarsal tumor which comes here, and I treated this patient, ma'am, with calcarea fluor 3x and medorhinum 200 and 1m given as an intercurrent. And then we have seen a couple of patients of chalazion. These are hard tumors, hard benign tumors here, and with good medicine, with good biochemic and the constitutional treatment, one can conquer this chalazion quite easily. Then we have retinopathies, diabetic retinopathy and the hypertensive retinopathy, where the patient's vision starts reducing grossly. Well, all these drugs which were listed here can help to a certain extent. The damage which has been done because of hypertension can't be reversed. The damage done because of diabetes can't be reversed. Hence, diabetes and hypertension are one of the two biggest killers and biggest culprits causing multiple illnesses all over the body. So one should not really take this lightly. And even for the eye, diabetes and blood pressure play havoc. Let us treat diabetes and blood pressure properly, and the eye conditions also won't occur. Having said this, I would like to conclude saying that take care of your eyes. Eyes are the most important object, most important areas. And let's conclude. I always like to conclude with a nice song, if you allow me. Wo gaana hai na? Teri aankhon ke siva duniya mein rakha kya? Toh main ulta karta hoon usko. Meri. सब आदमी मेरी आंखों के सिवा ना मेरी आंखों के सिवा दुनिया में रखा क्या है मेरी आंखों के सिवा दुनिया में रखा क्या है ये झुके सुबह तले ये उठे शाम ढले मेरा जीना मेरा मरना इन्हीं आँखों के तले. Thank you. Hope you liked it. Now I would like to take questions of gentlemen. Yeah.
Macular degeneration is only because of aging or?
Very good. Sir's question is macular degeneration only because of aging? The answer is yes. Aging is one of the important.
Something else.
Yeah, you have a point. That's what I'm saying. Aging is one of the factors. But why it should occur in many people in 50s nowadays, in 60s nowadays? So this is multifactorial. There are many theories. Some drugs are supposed to cause, some even steroids are supposed to known to cause this. There are many theories which, and yet no one really knows what exactly happens. It's a small mutation, many people say. Some people say it's all genetics, that they have isolated a gene which says that it is hereditary also. So there are multifactorial theories of macular degeneration. Yes, Sonali sahab? Yeah, I'll later conclude.
What can you do apart from?
See, floaters in the eyes are because of many states. Severe hypertension also can cause floaters. Even high myopia can cause floaters. Even something falls down, tom, can cause floaters. Even migraine can sometimes give rise to floaters, because migraine with aura, the classical migraine is known. So in homeopathy, we treat symptomatically. Okay, as if seeing through a wheel. A patient says that aise lagta hai ki I am seeing through a chadar, a wheel. A green hue, a purple hue, phosphorus, alumina, all these drugs have such symptoms. Opium has such symptoms. So we treat symptomatically, but the underlying cause should be removed. If you treat patient and he has hypertension, then we can't. If he has huge diabetes, he has got grade 3 retinopathy, then how can we help him? Yeah. Sahab?
My friend has got eyes, treat as big. When you see, one feel that it may fall down. It is so bad, big and red.
Acha. Now, what is his? What is his age? His or hers?
68.
68. बचपन में बहुत देखा होगा लड़कियों के पास, इसलिए आग बाहर आ गया. Anyway, point is that, you know, many a times people have big eyes. It's anatomical, it's an anatomical variant. बोलते ना, अरे इसकी आँख कितनी बड़ी है. Not that he's always angry. And as ma'am said right now, that certain states like hyperthyroidism or Graves' disease, what we call, can have big eyes. You know, where the proptosis and the, you can see the conjunctiva, all these signs, you can see this. But many people have eyes which are anatomically set this way that they are big. There may not be any medical condition and we may not be able to treat also. Okay, so this is, ask him to wear some nice specs to...
No.
He has a point. If this gentleman has developed this since last 1 or 2 years, then I think it warrants a good investigation, at least a basic baseline investigation along with thyroid profile, and also X-ray needs to be done, because maybe if there is a space occupying lesion, you know, pushing, but again it can be bilateral, it may be one eye. So the reasons can be many, or it may be of no reason. Okay. I am not well versed with this, but to the best of my knowledge, it may not be anything also, but let us get the basic investigations done. Yes, Lal Sahab. Yeah, very good. Sir's question is that when you sit on the computer, it becomes heavy. The answer is that first of all, one should not sit in front of computer for such a long time. I mean, Facebook is interesting, emails are interesting, or PowerPoints are interesting, but one should not sit for a huge amount of time. And one should see that if you are viewing at the computer, the area around the laptop should not be totally dark. It should be well lit up so that there is no much of strain. And one easy, nuska, jaise hum kehte hain, wash your eyes with cold water, or at least do some palming regularly. Sleep well for 8 to 10 hours, okay? And don't continuously keep on gazing at the computer. Give some watch at greenery and come back and start working. But well, answer to your question is that if you have continuous work and if you want to do it, some exam, some project, Natrum-Mur can be a good drug of choice, which we just told this gentleman. Yeah. Yes, ferrum-fos, Kali-Mur, Belladonna. Even Kali-Mur, in fact, is the first stage of inflammation. Kali-Mur is called as the biochemic sulfur. Why? Because first stage of inflammation. You know, there is lots to be discussed, but we don't have so much of time, and this is may not be a Matra Medica class.
And for daily,
very good question. You know, what ma'am is saying, that should one person keep taking something for eye care? The answer is no. In homeopathy, we believe that unless there is some epidemic, or unless you are going to be exposed to something unusual, we should not take medication. Homeopathy believes in least medication. So, answer to this is what our parents have been telling us. God knows how they knew it. They didn't have our grandparents. They didn't have media, but they knew it. Because of experience, wash your eyes with water every day. When you come home, wash your feet. Acupuncturists will say that yes, there are a lot of areas there which are important. So many times a headache is relieved by washing your feet in warm water or just having a good bath. So all these basic things should be done. One's diet should be full of vitamin A. You know, I tell all my patients, at least children, you must give egg every day, carrot juice. Okay, all these dry fruits also, calcium, vitamin, all this to be done. And if this is done, then one will not have.
Palming after heavy strain
also. It's very helpful, very helpful. General hygiene and maintenance of eye care, if it's done, one does not need anything as such.
One of the natural treatments is to make the patient walk or post grass.
Yes. That's yeah, very important, very interesting. It's very good. Yes. Is anything else? Thank you. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you.